everybody there watching Sony Music TV, wake up! This is the Michael Monroe special. Keep watching. I think it's very nice that they're giving very flattering. It's really nice that they're doing that kind of promotion. It works both ways too. I mean, me having Axel on my video also is, in a way, it works good for him too. I mean, I'm not saying he needs the exposure, but it's a certain respect for him on rocks that it's not very easy to gain. And if I have him on my video, people thought, oh, Axel must be totally cool. But I think it's very nice and very, very helpful. And they're obviously big fans, and I appreciate their honesty that they're saying that in the interviews. It's really good for me, so thank you, Axel. Thank you, Sebastian. God bless you.
マイケル・モンローの魅力ですよね。偉大なミュージシャンっていうのは、ミック・ジャガーにしてもデビッド・ボーイにしても、それからジミー・ペイジとかロバート・プラントもそうだったと思うんですけどね、やっぱりその男性的な部分と女性的な部分っていう2つのやっぱ表現力を持ってるんじゃないかなと思うんですよね。だからマイケル・モンローのファンっていうのは、男性のファンはね、男性らしさの中にそのなんか女性的な部分も見てるだろうし、女性のファンはね、マイケル・モンローに、その男性としての凄さと同時にやっぱ女性的な部分も見てると思うんですよ。それをまあカリスマ性と呼ぶかどうかは別にしてもね、そういうその男性的な部分、女性的な部分、ナイーブさと激しさというのを自分の心の中に持って、それをこうステージで表現してるわけですよね。だからその男性的な部分は汗だろうし、それから女性的な部分はステージでのなんか眼差しとか、そういう部分だと思うんですよね。そういう部分が彼のまあ魅力かなと思いますね。それとまあインタビューなんか見てても皆さんなんか感じてるかもしれないですけども、自分に嘘ついてないっていうところがいいと思うんですよね。そう、やっぱりこういろんなミュージシャンの中にはその言葉を選んでかっこいい言葉でなんか自分表現するっていう人が多いんですけど、彼はすごく分かりやすい言葉でね、自分のこう思ってることを本当に正直にこう告白してる人だなと思うんですよね。まあ、そういう意味でそのなんていうかな、友達を大事にしてるし、それでなんかこう人の言ったことっていうのは忘れないで覚えてるし、例えば日本のスタッフの人だってみんな名前覚えてますよね、マイケル・モンローは。そういうところにね、彼の人柄っていうのも出てる。やっぱりミュージシャンっていうのはね、ステージ上でやっぱステージ上ですごいことを表現しても、私生活になるともうダラダラしてる人もいるわけで、まあ、それもまあ美しさかもしれないけどね、マイケル・モンローはそうじゃなくて、私生活もステージでもすごくプライドを持って生きてて、そして優しさがあるなってところがいいとこかなと思うんですけども、まあ、人それぞれですからね。だから僕ここが大阪なんですけどね、僕も大阪まで見に来てるっていうのは、そういう彼の人柄に惚れてきてるわけですからね、そういうところが魅力かなと思います。
Yeah, I can clarify that it is a rumor. It's a rumor, there's no truth to it. Well, it's an exciting thought though, but that's news to me. I heard about it, it was in the Kerrang magazine already. Yeah, Steve's a nice guy, a great guitar player, but that's news to me. I don't know anything about it. So I don't know. I don't know where that started, I've known him. I've known him sort of, for a long time, and people's, if I go out somewhere and I run into him or something, people see us together, maybe they start making stories, because it's an exciting idea, all lies. It's a nice rumor though, it's good, yeah, right? Yeah, but it's not... No,
just a rumor.
It's just a rumor. He's so far, this is as far as I know. I'm just gonna probably commit suicide. Nah. After Japan, I have no plans yet. It remains to be seen. I heard, we're kind of waiting to see what the record company is waiting to see what's happening with the single Man with No Eyes. And as usual, I think they're probably not this record company, but not in Japan, but over in America, Polygram. It seems like, as usual, they're gonna fail. So I think they're gonna put out another single. Probably put out another single. See, I let them choose Man with No Eyes. This is the first. They did rock and roll. They didn't really work it that much. Mm-hmm. They didn't know. And their excuse was that it was my choice. Mm-hmm. So I said, okay, next time you pick the single. Oh. And they picked Man with No Eyes. Mm. I said, okay. And then we make a video. And what the video was about was what the song was about. And I said, okay, you asked for it. And I made a heavy video.
Mm-hmm. Right.
But and they were working on it. And it was doing pretty good. But I think they're probably losing it by now. So they probably want to put out another single. Mm-hmm. But this time I'm going to choose it.
Ah, なるほどね。
And I would think it would be maybe while you were looking at me.
Yeah.
Or She's No Angel or Fake, or rather Rocket.
Yeah, good song. Good song. Yeah. Okay. Mm-hmm.
これアメリカ人とかさ、イギリス人のそのロッカーと違ってね、なんていうの、すごい真面目なんだよね、ちょっと違って。で、ふざけた感じももちろんあるけども、全然そのアメリカ人がふざけてるとか、イギリス人がふざけたロッカーじゃなくてね、本当になんか、シーンはすっごい真面目なの。まあ、過去をね、いろんな話聞いたけども、ああいう過去を持ってる割には、すごい真面目だしね、だからそこのところがね、結局、本当になんていうのかな、上っ面のね、真面目さとか自分はすごいいい人間なんだよってじゃなくてね、本当心底もね結構真面目なんだからね、まあ、そこのところがね結局ファンにも対しても、まあ、伝わってんじゃないかなと。特に今マイケルのファンって若い子がすごい多いんだけど、まあ、アイドル的な存在だからね、若い子多いんだけど、でもだから彼女たちにとって、まあ、男の子がいるんだけど、彼女にとってもすごいそこには伝わってんじゃないかなって気がする。で、一時のその、まあ、彼はそのヘビーメタルとかそういうハードロックと違って、やっぱりそのロックンロールなんですけど、ずいぶん昔に言ったジャパンのね、いやファンがね、やっぱりね、ジャパンの時のファンとすごく似た感じがあるのね。いわゆる今ずいぶんなかったけど、いわゆるそのベイシティとかね、ああいうやつが入った頃のファンみたいなファンがまた今出てきた。一時ああいうファンってすっごいなくなっちゃったから、でも今そういうのがすごい出てきてるし、まあ、同じ傾向のファンだなっていう感じだね。だから一種のやっぱり今までまたしばらくなくなってたそのアイドルが久々に誕生したんじゃないかなっていう、まあ、スキドローとかと比べてやっぱりそれ同じアイドルなんだけど、もっとその、ね、少し年齢が高いねファンだから、彼らのファンの場合でもマイクの場合って本当いわゆる邦楽っていうか邦楽を聴いてたね子供たちが初めてその洋楽に入って、さあ何を聴こうって時にさあマイクのモンローだっていうね、だからすごいいい形で出てきたんじゃないかな。だからこれがやっぱりファンも若いし、まあ、マイケルももっともっとね、本人はやっぱり大きいところをもっとファン欲しいみたいな感じだし、一生懸命やっているから、うん、まあ、どっちとしても、まあ、もちろんみんなの協力が必要だけど、やっぱそれでやっぱり大きくしていきたいな
と。やっぱし、歌もうまいし、パフォーマンスもきっちりしてるし、あんだけステージやるやつはいないんじゃないかと。やっぱミック・ジャガー、亡き後は、
Well, first of all, it was great doing the video here. It was great to have. It's good promotion for you guys too, right? Right?
Yeah.
Now since you own half the country there, everybody's talking about, oh, the Japanese are taking over. But you know, you're smarter and more organized. So, it's in America, no one cares. So, they're screwing up. I think the video was very special. I'm really proud of the piece, actually. Mm. To make it here, and we had the big crowd. And what the song is really about is about dictators, people in power who abuse their power, and people who suffer in the process. And to me, it was appropriate that it was on a big stage and a big crowd for me, because in the end, it's you know, I could be that person too. Mm. I have the power, but I use it for positive. Mm. Now. Having this, you know, shooting some scenes in the streets with neon lights and talking, which I love, I always did. And point is very strong. It made a strong statement. Mm. And MTV, they're playing it on, I think it's medium right there, honestly, heavy, but medium. They're really pushing me. They're working on it hard, and I appreciate that. Mm-hmm. Only thing though, they had to censor the video. They cut out some parts because it made a bit of a too strong of a statement. You know, MTV don't want you to. You know, I appreciate all they're doing for me, but to inform me. But funnily enough, the video was it was re-edited. I had to make another version for them to play because the original version was a little too heavy for them. But it's funny because I think I spoke to the director who was Russian originally, and he said, he said in Russia they would show that video without no censorship, you know? So I mean, like, who's who? What's what? Who's you know, controlling the people or what? You know? I mean, I guess they don't want you to really react too emotionally or whatever, but to me, that's more, that's what I'd like to do, you know, make people react to me and make a statement. And it's the song was saying something very serious, and not that serious, but it is about what's going on in the world, and it's not only, not definitely not just Japan, it's just what we did in Japan, but it's what's going on all over the world. There's a lot of news footage, which kids have seen. Oh, you know, people see it all the time on TV. But then you put it on a video. Hey, this is supposed to be entertainment, you know. So I think it was very, it must have been a good video since they had to censor it. But it made a strong statement. I'm really proud of that piece. I think it's probably the best video I've done.
I see.
It's nice though that MTV is supporting me, because I don't know what's happening with the American record company, you know. Because in America you gotta get to MTV and then you gotta get you on the radio. The radio is really what, you know, they work together. If one of them doesn't work, then, you know, only if you're lucky you break, you know. But I'm happy as things are, you know. Still doing my thing. As you know, all I ever asked for was a roof over my head.